to our Decorate and Design series. I am Jenny with Eternal Love Crafts and Photography, and today I will be showing you how to make this beautiful chandelier floral centerpiece. This will be a two-part video. In part one, I will show you how to make the base chandelier part of the centerpiece, and in part two, I will show you how we make the floral arrangement for the top of this chandelier centerpiece. The materials we will be using to make this centerpiece will be stand number 3 that we made with our support base series video. So we're going to take the stand number 3, and in addition to that, we're going to need a plastic plate, which we will prep and make all the appropriate indicators on the plate, but I will show you later on the video how we did that. In addition, we will need 9mm jump rings, a styrofoam that is about, I believe, 5 inches in diameter. Here you'll see I'm tracing the outline of the octagon of the base of the stand so that it'll be easier when I glue it on that I know the exact center of the plate to the stand. Here you'll see is the styrofoam that I mentioned. It's a 5-inch diameter styrofoam. It fits exactly the middle section of the plate. And I did put a hole in the middle as well so that the tea light can go through it, so it will shine right through to give us the lining that we need, which I will talk about later on how I did all that. These are the 9mm jump rings that I'm using to go all around the rim of the plate. The plate requires about 68 jump rings because I made the equal distance around each dot is about 1/4 inch apart. And then you're gonna use a heating tool to punch holes into those dots that we created, and so that the jump rings can go into each of those holes. So let's get started of how we're gonna create these things. First, with the plastic plate, I first measured out with a ruler the distance to make all the dots in between. So that, like I said, is 1/4 inch for all the dots, and you would get about 68 dots. Then I took the tea light and I put it in the center. I centered it on the plate and I traced the circle of the tea light so I know exactly where I will cut my incision to get the hole in the center of the plate. Then I put the stand on top and I traced it the octagon of the stand to get the dimension of the middle of the stand. Here, I already used my heating tool, which is a heating cutting tool, to cut out the hole of the center. And also, I used the pointy part of the heating soldering tool to poke the holes into each part of the plate. So I already pre-done that. And it's pretty simple. Once you heat the heating tool to the right temperature, it goes in very easily and it pokes out the holes very easily as well. Now with our styrofoam, I put the tea light right in the middle and I traced it the circle around the styrofoam. Then I used our heating cutting tool and I cut out a hole where I made the markings, and the hole, the size that you make depends on which type of tea light you want to put there. I'm putting a small tea light in this one, so I just traced it to circumference so that once I cut it out, it will fit the tea light. Then I also, if you noticed, I also placed dots around the styrofoam. That is so that I know when I put my plate on top where to center the plate. Now I'm gonna glue the top piece of the plate onto the styrofoam. And after that, I'm gonna glue the plate onto the stand. The stand's right here. See the full stand? Onto the stand right here. So I first have to mix the mixture of the Gorilla Glue. So usually you would want to wear gloves to do the mixture, but I'm just gonna do it without the gloves. So make it a little easier for myself. But you might want to wear gloves for this part. So as I showed in the previous videos, it's really simple to mix together. You just uncap the Gorilla Glue. Now make sure it's not leaking. Mine is a little bit leaking. I guess I didn't cap it well the last time I used it. So it's a little bit leaky. But as you can tell, I used like most of my Gorilla Glue already. I have a little bit left. So I'm going to use it for two projects with the Gorilla Glue. But with the Gorilla Glue, it dries up really quickly. So I recommend just squeezing a little bit out for this part. And then when you need to use more, you squeeze some more out and you mix it. Just so you can save yourself the Gorilla Glue, because it does harden rather quickly. And because it hardens rather quickly, it's, you have to use it right away. So I usually just squeeze and use a little bit. There you go. It's coming out. Okay, and then you just pull it back to get back the pressure, and so it'll flow back in. You should give it a tap. And I'm gonna close back the cap there. Actually, I forgot which direction I had the original one. Not good sign. You might want to remember which one you put as which, because one's hardener and one's the other one. So mixing it up is not that great. So I forgot which cap I used. So just put that aside. And here's my stirring stick. I'm just going to mix the two together until you have a good mixture of like well mixed. So you're gonna get a good emulsion mixture, and then you'll know once it becomes thickened and it becomes a little bit yellowish white color, because one of the sides is yellow color and the other is like white. So when you mix it together, you get this yellowish white color. So you'll know. So if I do the mixture, it's like well mixed already. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna apply it onto my styrofoam. I actually never used this Gorilla Glue on styrofoam, but I'm gonna glue styrofoam to the plastic plate, so hopefully it's gonna adhere well to it. If it doesn't, I'm gonna use the E6000, but I hope it adheres well, because I really do like the Gorilla Glue for the reason that it holds quickly after 5 minutes. So that's one of the features about the Gorilla Glue I like versus the E6000, which takes a long time to set in. So just give it like a generous amount all around. You might want to use, I only have the stick, the wooden stick, that's why I'm using this. But you might want to use like a popsicle stick or something wider, because then it can make it a little easier to spread out the glue. But I just had this wooden piece stick, so I just want to use that. I had it lying around, so I was like, okay, why not? I'll use that. So I just give it a good spread. I think I spread it good enough. I think I'm out of the glue already, so it's good enough. Okay, now I'll put this aside and I'm gonna bring back my plate. And how I'm gonna do it is this. I'm gonna place it down
I'm gonna find the right placement for it so that it'll be centered. I want it to, the circle and the plate to be centered. So what I did was I put like little dots on the styrofoam to help guide me along. Should work. And what I also did to guide me when I stick the plastic plate onto the stand, I drew the outline onto the plastic plate of where I'm going to put the stand base. So that should help me along as well. Okay, so I'm gonna, now that I got this centered in, I'm gonna turn it around. It was centered. No, it's not centered yet. Now centered. I'm gonna turn it around and I'm gonna put some pressure on it. I'm not sure if it's holding it well, but if it's not, what I will do, put some pressure. What I will do is I'm gonna add some of the E6000 glue to hold it down even further. So I'm gonna pull out some of the E6000 glue. E6000 glue. So I'm gonna use some of that as well. I don't think it's holding. It's not holding very well. So I'm gonna glue that all around and I'm gonna put a generous amount all around. And hopefully, because I don't know how styrofoam like holds in. I didn't want to use the hot glue gun. I just didn't feel like turning that on. So hopefully this will do the trick and it will hold it well and it'll do the job. Let's see what happens. Okay, so give it a few taps. And I'm gonna lean against here. And okay, so again, I'm gonna put this down. I'm gonna try to find the center of this. You'll know it because it has like the round rim around it, so you just try to find the center of that. So this is just kind of centered. And then I'm gonna turn it upside down. And I'm gonna push on it. Push down on it. And I'm gonna put some heavy weights on it. Here we go. This one is the right size. That is actually the base that I'm using as the weight, because it is rather really heavy. So hopefully that will hold it down a little bit. I'm going to actually turn it the other way, because I think that will be even more weight on it, and it's more centered weight. So I'm gonna let it sit for a little bit. I'm gonna put pressure on it. I'm gonna let it sit for a little bit. Hopefully it'll hold. And we'll get back to the next step. Now that our stand have time to dry, we're going to turn this upside down and then we're going to start adding these little 9mm jump rings on the rim of the plates. I already started and added half of the plate already, and in addition I added some of the string beads on I only had 6 string beads, so I added it every few distance. I added a string bead. So with the holes here, the distance that we made all the rings was about 1/4 inch apart. And I only added 6 here, but I'm gonna add all of it, later on, but I just wanted to add it at an equal distance so that I can see how visually it's gonna look like. So I added 5 here, and I did half of the rings, put it in already. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn this upside down. It's easier to do it upside down, adding the rings in, and then we'll turn it back up, right side up, when we're done adding all the rings, the jump rings, to the little holes over there. Okay, so now what you'll need is you'll need some pliers, preferably 2 pliers. I only found 1. I don't know why I put the second one, so I'm just gonna use 1 plier for now and with my hands do what you would have done with the second plier. It's a lot easier if you have 2 pliers though, so I recommend using 2 pliers. And what you do is, these are the little jump rings. These are the 9mm jump rings, which is I recommend. The 7mm they also sell, but it's too small to fit into the little rings around, because when we made the holes, we wanted a little distance away from the edge, so that just in case it doesn't crack, it doesn't break or anything like that. So that's why the 9mm jump rings work very well. So these jump rings, I got them from Michaels, but you can get them at any arts and crafts store. So what I do is, if you had 2 pliers, you would use 2 pliers and it would be easier, you wouldn't hurt your fingers and stuff. But since I only had 1, I only found 1 of my pliers, so I'm using 1. So I use the other one, I use my hand to hold it, and then it'll pull it apart, and then you'll make a gap in the jump ring. And then that's when you find the hole on the plate that you created, and you're gonna insert the jump ring inside. It's easy to go from the top down because the hole was made from the front of the plate, so once you find the placement, you just slide it right in there. Then once it slides in there, if you had the string beads, you would put the string beads in at the same time before you close it. But since I don't have all the string beads with me yet, I have to prepare those. So I'm just gonna put in the jump rings and have it all around the plate. So that's what I'm doing in this step. And then I just make sure I close the jump ring as best as you can. You don't have to close it all the way, as long as it's close enough so that it doesn't fall off the plate. When it goes dangling, it doesn't fall out. That's the goal. With these jump rings, if you close it all the way, it's okay too. It's just that later on, when you add the string beads on, you have to reopen them again. So I just had one hanging right there. And I already had some string beads added again, like I said, just to see how it would look like. I only had 6 string beads, so that's why I only added the 6. I added 5. I have 1 more here to show you, so that's why I didn't add it yet, how I would add the string beads in. So with the plate, you can definitely turn it and have like distance with it. I think when I made my stand, I made it a little crooked, because I can see it now. It's a little slightly crooked. It's more crooked towards the right hand side, which explains why when I turn the whole thing upside down, right side up actually, because this is upside down, when I turned it right side up, it wasn't very level. The plate was like a little tilted up and tilted down. So that has to do with the mechanism of when I glued together the strand, the different pieces to make up the stand itself. I think when I glued the margarita cup on top of the stand, I think it's a little tilted. So that would explain the little small tilt, but the tilt is not super noticeable. It's a little slightly noticeable, but once we add the flowers on top, I think it's gonna work out regardless of it being a little tilted. So we'll see how it looks afterwards, and make modifications if needs be. So So I'm just continue to add more of these jump rings onto my plate, going all the way around. So now up to the part, I'm gonna add a, show you how to add a string bead on. So first we're gonna put the jump ring into the plate hole first. Okay, so you're gonna put it in and you slide it in like that, and see there's the gap from the jump ring that you created with the string beads. Is it one string bead here? Here, the amount of jump rings I added onto this whole plate with the distance of a quarter inch is 68. So you will need 68 jump rings. You need to punch in 68 holes onto the plate. And then with the string beads, you have to choose the direction you want the bead to face, because this string bead does not have the rings, the metal rings that connect each bead. It's like a string that connects each bead. So instead of like gluing, you have a choice. If you didn't want to make any holes, you can glue individual beads onto the plate, and then you have a whole string full of the string beads making the chandelier stand, which makes this chandelier centerpiece. But I didn't want to do working with glue because I just didn't like the outcome of working with glue, and it gets really messy. So instead I found this other idea where you put the beads through the jump rings. So in between each bead, if you look closely, there's like a section of the string that connects each bead together. So that is what we're going to place into the jump ring, that little gap right here into the jump ring. So you have to find the direction that you want it to be, because you want it, the whole thing, to be consistent. So what I did was I put all the first bead facing to the left of the ring. So if you can see it here, it's facing the left of the ring. So the same thing I'll do here. I'll put it in facing the left. Look, my hand's kind of covering it, but you'll see closely. See right here. I placed it to the left, of the jump ring. So once you place it to the left, let me just slide it down, and just so that I have room to close my jump ring with my pliers, I'm gonna close the gap, the jump ring gap. I'm just gonna apply it together. Make sure it's like a tight closure, because you don't want the string part to fall out. So just try to close it as best as possible, connecting the jump ring closure part. So I did that, and that's it. That's very simple. It's now facing to the left, and then you have a bead shan that's connected right to the plates from the jump ring that we added on. So I have one more jump ring to add on. And then I completed adding all the 68 jump rings onto this plate. And then we can go on to the next step, which is I'm gonna add the rest of the, I think 62 bead strands, crystal bead strands onto this plate to make the chandelier part of the base. So I just add that in there and I'm gonna close the jump ring. Like so. And that's it. I added all of the jump rings onto this plate.
Here I'm featuring a crystal garland bead strand curtain that I purchased. It's 9 feet long by 3 feet wide. And these are the bead strands that I used for this project as well as from other projects that I'm using it as well. And I really like it because it's a lot of bead strands, crystal garlands. So, and you can cut them down to the size that you need.
Now that we have our crystal bead strands that we separated from our hanging curtain bead strand, each one of them is about 20 to 29 beads long, and now we're gonna attach them onto our jump rings that we have right here. These are the jump rings. I don't know if you can see them. Let me go up close. So all these are the little jump rings that we already added on here. So we're gonna start attaching each of these bead strands. So each one of these bead strands are about 28 to 29 beads long, and that's the height that we want once we attach it for our stand. So we're gonna start attaching those onto all these rings here, and after I attach them, then we'll be right back. So stay tuned.
Now that all the crystal bead strands has been attached to our plate, you shall see a chandelier stand. So this is what the outcome of our chandelier stand it looks like. And we will be adding lighting on the inside, one on the bottom and one in the top where we made the hole for the styrofoam. That will be a light on top and a light on the bottom. And the effect that you see when you shut off the lights looks very amazing and it's really beautiful. So stay tuned to part 2 of our video to see how I created the floral design for the top of this chandelier centerpiece. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up, and if you haven't done so already, subscribe to our channel. We love getting comments from our subscribers, so definitely give us a comment below. And if you have any questions, concerns, do give us a comment. Also, if you have suggestions for our future videos, do comment on that as well. So till next time, continue to DIY.